Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and if you don't know who I am, my name is Lisa. I am a cruelty-free YouTuber that does a lot of makeup content. And today, I am super excited. If you didn't know, Nabla has released two new cutie palettes, and I have bought them. So, I'm going to test out both today. They released a Midnight and Analogue. So I'm going to use these two today, and I did order these from Nabla's own site, and it goes so fast to ship from Italy to Sweden, like faster than inside of Sweden. And I also bought two other things. I bought a skin glazing powder, a blush in the color Lola that looks like this. I have one that is dark red and I really like that one, so I wanted one more. And then I also bought their new mascara. Kinda new. This is Vicious and Alice, you know who you are. You made me buy this because you said this was amazing. But okay, I think the palette is like the most fun in this, so I will use them both at the same time. So I will do one eye with one of the palettes and the other eye with the other palette. I can actually show you these. And I have all of Nabla's palettes except for one of the glitter quads. So this is number 6 and this is Midnight, the blue one. And it looks like this. I think this is a really cute little palette because it is a cute palette. But it looks like this. So this is a blue palette and I think they've done it really good for only 6 shades. And it's going to be fun to use this. And the other one is Analogue and this is more neutral. It looks like this. This is maybe like a deeper version of the cute palette Nude. So this is Analogue and I think the middle shade in the top row looks so good. I don't know if I can show you, but it is like a duochrome. So yeah, I actually have no idea what I want to do with these, but I think we just get started and I will start to do the eye with number 6, Midnight. So for the Midnight palette, I'm going to start with Air, this light one, and put it in my crease. I'm going to take away the plastic of this mirror. So I will just put this in my crease. We will see where we will go from there. I haven't decided yet what I want to do actually. Okay, I don't know. Maybe this won't show up on me. Yeah, a little bit. It's a really light shade and not like that blue. I don't think I would. Is this a transition shade? Maybe not. I'm using kind of a fluffy brush. I get some out of it. And now I have to remember to not do it on the other eye. So I think this maybe is not an ideal shade to have in your crease. I need to go in a lot. I think that is enough. And I think I want to do, I think it's too much to do like a halo on one eye and not a halo on the other eye. So I think I'll do like a half cut crease on both of the eyes. So I will go in with Blue Hour, this dark one, and put it out here. And then I have to think a little bit which shade to take as a half cut crease. And okay, we will see now. Nabla isn't the best with doing blue shades. I know in the Poison Garden palette, the blue in that one, people hated it. Most people at least. But okay, this looks good. I think I also want to take it a little bit up in my crease. Okay, I don't know. It feels like I'm blending this away a little bit. when I'm packing it on and like try to blend it. I don't know. It looks really good in the crease, but on the eye, maybe I just need to pack it on. Yeah, I'm not super thrilled about this shade. I'm going in with my crease brush with nothing more on and just blending it a little bit. It looks really good in the crease, I can't say anything about that. Like out here, it feels like it's blending away a little bit. I think I will have it like that. So now the question is, what do I want to have on my cat crease? I don't want to use this one because I want to use the blue shades, but I don't know if I want to use Sapphire or Quiet Storm. I think Quiet Storm is more like a topper, but maybe I should try and see how it looks. I do that. And I will try without the glitter glue. We will see how this goes. I think this is more like a topper shade. Or maybe not. Maybe this is working. I know if like I would have gone in with a glitter primer, it would have looked super cool. But I think that this works. I just need to pack it on rather than blending it on, swipe it on. I want to take it a little bit on top of the blue here. Just see how it looks. It looks a little bit more blue out there, maybe. I don't know. I'm just going in with a little bit more of the matte blue. Just blending it. Okay, so is this all I want to do with this eye? I think I want to go in with this Alma as my inner corner highlight, but I am doing that last. I just think though that I want to take the blue, the deep blue, and have it in my whole crease. So in here as well. So far I'm okay with this eye. I'm not loving the matte deep blue I have out here because it feels like it's not the best blue, but that's all for now. So let's go into the other eye. So for the other eye, one thing I know is I want to go in with overexposed, this one, because it looks just amazing. I'm going to see if I can show you. You see it? It's like pink and gold. But the question is then, what do I want to use more? I think I go in with this contact sheet and camera roll in my crease. And I think that Nabla, they do amazing neutral palettes. I really love like the Secret Garden palette that is maybe half neutral, half colorful palette. And I also really, really like Side by Side. And I think they are so good at doing neutral shades. And they are good at doing some more fun shades, but it's not like they don't have that, like, they don't have rainbow palette, which I'm kind of happy for. But I think really like neutral is their thing. And I have actually nothing against it. But they also do fun palettes, but they are not like too crazy. Get what I mean? But I still really like them. And I don't know if I need to go in with something more in my crease, but I will actually take camera roll this one just a little bit on my brush. Tip it away and then, ooh. these two together. A really nice combo. So, for my eyelid, I think I will go in with Dark Room. And that, I think this might be satin. I'm so bad at like checking things up. But in their Cuter palette, they have like more latex maybe and satin shades. Don't quote me on that. Never quote me on anything. But it's not matte, but it's not shimmer. But I think I will go in with Dark Room and then Overexposed. So we will see how this Dark Room look. Hopefully. Kinda dark. And this is one of their... I don't know if it might be latex shades. So it's like not matte, but it's not shimmer. It's an in-between thing. Okay, so I think this is a good deeper brown, at least on me. And the one thing I like with this, it's I can blend it up in my crease without any problems at all. Okay, so I think we're going with Overexposed then. I guess it might be... I'm going to swatch it actually. It feels a little bit like this shade, but maybe not. We will see how this look. So this might be a shade that is better to go in with the glitter primer. But I'm not going to do that. Or am I? I might should do that because this is kind of light. I think I actually will do that. I will go in with glitter primer. And it's like sometimes I'm a little bit against it because it feels like I'm cheating. But at the same time, I don't think this shade is made for being on its own. Okay, so now we'll try again with Overexposed. Okay, I think this is more like a topper, or if you really want to do something. A really light makeup, but like want to add on a little bit of extra. I guess that this would be amazing for that. But I don't know, I feel it has such a light base, this shade, so it's a little bit hard to know where it is. Not where it is, but I hope you get what I mean. Do I look a little bit crazy? Probably. But, and I don't know where to put my things, but yeah. I think I'm done with eyes like this. So I'm going to take away the fallouts, fix my base, and I will use this one. I will see if I will film it, maybe not, because I've tried one of these before. Now I have hair in my mouth. So I will fix my base and my brows, and then I come back for the under eyes, and then I'm going to give you my like first impression review, first impression on the palettes. So yeah, I will fix the base and then I come back. For my lower lash line, I think I just want to go in with the blue, the dark blue on this eye, and I think the brown on this eye. So I will start with the blue one. I did pick out two brushes for this. So I'm going to take Blue Hour, and I think I'll take it on my whole lower lash and then put Alma in my inner corners and inner corner highlight. Let's hope that this will not fall on my face, so I will tap it off. And then just try to smudge it. Okay, so it worked really, really good on my lower lash. So maybe it works better with like a denser brush than the one that I had on my lid. I don't know. Okay, I am going to just take Alma then with my pinky and just put it in my inner corner. And the blue eye is done. So So I go into the more neutral eye. And I think I will take dark room on my whole lower lash. Maybe I should take... No, I will take it. We'll see how this works. Hopefully good. This is so freaking pigmented. So maybe it was a little bit too dark to take on my whole lower lash. But you know what? The damage is already done. And for my inner corner highlight on this eye, I will go in with 35mm. I go in with it with my pinky. So I will pop something in my waterline. I will also try the Vicious mascara. I really like their other mascara. Major Pleasure, I think it's called. So I will see how this is. So I will put this on, put a lipstick on, and then I come back. So for my waterline on the blue eye, I took one from NYX that is Love. And on the other eye, I took a brown from ColourPop that is Call Me. And on my lips, I took Rumors from Nabla. I love this. This is one of my favorite reds. I think it is just an amazing deeper red. And I also actually tried the mascara. I really like it. I think I have... The lashes look good. And I really like the wand of it. I can show you. It's a silicone wand. And it's really easy to get like hold of all the lashes. So this one. Really good. I will just see how it will hold up. So. A little review maybe on the palette. I have only used them once. But at the same time I have used all other palettes from Nabla. I have used all the other Cutie palettes. And we can maybe start with the blue one, the Midnight. I think it looks good. I do wish that they could have had something else than this, because I think that this would suit another palette better. It would be fun if they did a whole blue palette. But other than that, I haven't tested all the shades. I have tested 4 of the shades. I think this matte blue, I had to work a little bit with it, but I think it looks good now. And this Quiet Storm, nothing to complain. I think it would have looked so much better if I would have taken a glitter glue or glitter primer, but I think it works. I just needed to pack it on. Pick it on? Pack it on kind of much. But I think it looks good. I have nothing to complain about. Is blue my favorite eyeshadows? No, it's not. But I think it has, the palette has the same quality as the other ones. So, nothing to complain about. And then if we take the analog, I know in Swedish you say analog, I don't know. I am not like a super neutral lover, but some of my absolute favorite neutral palettes is from Nabla. And I have nothing to complain about on this either. I really like how dark and intense this one was. It was really, really pigmented. And here I have used 5. This I had in my inner corner, so say 4. And this one and this one, they were perfect together. It looked really, really good in my crease. This overexposed, I think it's more like topper, or maybe just put it on your whole lid to have something a little bit extra. But I don't think the base wasn't that strong in this one. It was a really light shade. But I think now it looks really good. I though think the pink did get lost a little bit when I put on the glitter primer. But I think it looks good. I like this eye. Even though it's a neutral eye. And now I feel like, yeah, okay. Is this something that I don't like? The dark brown that I had on this eye, I don't think it's a super good shade to have on my lower lash, because it's starting to fall a little bit. So maybe don't have it on your lower lash. Maybe I could save it. I hope you don't see it. But yeah, I like this one as well. Maybe not the most fun cuter palette, but I like it. I think it's a little bit... I can actually show you. It's a bit of an... maybe not. Because the cuter palette nude... that looks like this. Maybe these would look good together to do a look with. I don't know. But I think that the mix in these two new palettes with mattes and all that formula is good, actually. So I think these are a little bit maybe more versatile. Not versatile, but a little bit easier to use and do different looks with, because like this has two mattes. And the darkroom you can use as you use a matte shade, but it's not a matte. I think it is one of the latex formula. I'm so sorry. So that I think is good, and I just love Nobla's cuter palette. I maybe should do like a cuter week on my channel now that they have 7 cuter palettes and do a look with each of the nuder palettes, cuter palettes. Let me know if you want that. And also I can talk a little bit about this one. I like it. I know that I would. It is really like... you can build it up. But I think it looks... it has a little bit of a sheen. But I don't think it is too much. So I really like this. This was in the color Lola. And I did actually use Ombra. The skin bronzing. And Ozone the... highlighter. I don't see shit. So yeah, I'm happy with this look. I like this eye the most. Sometimes I just love neutral shades. That's just how it is. But yeah, I really hope you like this video. And if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do. So you don't miss any of my videos. I can leave... I have done a Nobla week before when I used... was it 7 of my Nobla palettes I had back then? I can leave the playlist here if you want to check that out. But Nobla is one of my favorite brands. I guess I'm a little bit biased, but I like it. So yeah, I like it. So yeah, I really hope you liked this video, and I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!